The echo chamber of lies created by the mainstream media and its appendages is like the cave from Plato's notorious allegory. Those who use the internet to find their way out of the cave are startled to find that there's an entire world beyond the false narrative woven by the people who are desperate to control their perception of reality by any means necessary. Many of those who liberate themselves from this echo chamber retain feelings of concern and sympathy toward those still trapped within. But it's not uncommon for this concern and sympathy to translate into a sense of duty to liberate the rest of the cave dwellers. So some of those who liberate themselves return to the cave. But upon return, they find themselves personally attacked over every utterance that even seemingly contradicts the comfortable lies to which the cave dwellers have grown accustomed. These attacks become increasingly vitriolic until, eventually, those who have returned to inform the cave dwellers of the truth are forced to resign and permanently depart from the cave. In their absence, the echo chamber grows so cacophonous that its inhabitants are no longer able to produce their own original thoughts. Every now and then, a loud noise from outside the cave will permeate the cacophony of the echo chamber, but the cave dwellers always find a way to convince themselves and their comrades that they must have collectively imagined it, at which point they increase the volume of the echo chamber. Such is their hostility toward anything which might contradict the lies to which they've grown accustomed. Meanwhile, the quality of life inside the cave is deteriorating, and people are continuing to leave in greater numbers. Outside the cave, people freely engage in new conversations while forming new communities of their own. Eventually, so many of these communities are formed, and so many of these conversations are being had, that it becomes impossible for the cave dwellers to block out the noise from the outside. The echo chamber collapses in a cascade and the cave dwellers panic.
Oh my God, we're gonna die! No! I don't wanna die!
Well,
what happened?
They imagine it to be the end of the world.
Kill me! Kill me!
They had believed the lies of the echo chamber for so long, and those lies hadn't prepared them for the possibility of having to deal with differing opinions. They were utterly unprepared for it, and completely unfamiliar with how to put forth actual arguments to support their positions. So they rushed out of the cave and immediately began setting fires to the surrounding communities, without even waiting for their eyes to adjust to the sunlight.
Guys, thank you so much for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and share it on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. If you want to see more videos like this, click that big red subscribe button down there, and as soon as I upload a video, you'll be one of the first to see it. If you want to support this channel, pick up one of these hard-hitting, conversation-starting shirts. You'll find the link in the description below, along with a plethora of other hard-hitting, high-impact designs. Remember, guys, the price of freedom is eternal vigilance. And indifference to this notion is the means by which the people will secure their own oppression. Let's stop securing our own oppression and let's start today. I'll see you guys in the next video.